Hey everyone, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. Now today I'm going to discuss something that most of us, if not all of us, have drank from, and it increases both breast and prostate cancer. And I bring this up because both breast and prostate cancer rates have increased over the years, despite better and earlier screening and detection. However, the good news is that the survival rates have increased a little bit. Of course, there's lots of factors that can cause cancer. Primary ones are always going to be genetics and hormones. And there's one hormone both prostate and breast cancer have in common, and that's estrogen, both showing elevations in this female hormone for both cancers. Remember, both men and women obviously have this hormone. Women just have higher amounts. Now, this may make sense for people, you know, for women, right? Women have more estrogen. But why would it do so for men? Now, it's complicated, but as estrogen levels go up, DHT, this dihydrotestosterone levels, also go up as well because it's your body's natural estrogen inhibitor. DHT also causes hair loss. However, as both estrogen and DHT go up, both cause a decrease in the protective hormone, testosterone. You want testosterone to be high. Again, this is very simplistic, but that's the basic summary of it. Now, there's lots of reasons for higher estrogen levels, both endogenously, meaning internally, as well as exogenously, meaning externally. For example, fat cells produce more estrogen. Thus, the higher your body fat, the higher your estrogen. This would be an internal endogenous cause or reason. So one goal to lower your estrogen internally would be to decrease your body fat. Unfortunately, there's lots of external exogenous causes, from the foods we eat to the chemical toxins in the environment. However, today I want to focus on a major external toxin that causes estrogen, and that's BPA. Now, this is an environmental estrogen that's far more harmful to your body than natural estrogen. Basically, BPA is a man-made toxin. It's one of the most common synthetic chemicals which enters the human body from plastic bottles, food packaging, and even dental materials. It causes endocrine and hormonal disorders. It also increases your risk for testicular, prostate, and breast cancer. It's even linked to insulin resistance, higher blood sugar, and diabetes. The point is that BPA is very bad for you, and sadly, it's found almost everywhere. So I bring all this up because a major and primary source of BPA in most people is from plastic water bottles. Now, you may have already known or heard that plastic water bottles aren't good for you. They're basically bad for you. But you probably didn't know why or just how bad, especially as it relates to estrogen and increasing your risk for cancers such as breast and prostate cancer. So the first thing you need to do is stop using plastic bottles. They're horrible for the environment as well as your body. It's better to get maybe a water filter at home and fill up a glass bottle, or make sure you use only BPA-free plastic water bottles. Now, basically, you know, if it's BPA free, there should be a triangle at the bottom of the bottle with a number in the middle. And again, it's typically it's found at the bottom. Now, the following image shows you what's safe and what you should avoid. Basically, if you take a look here, you need to avoid number 3, 4, and 7. All right. Now, if you decide that you still want to use these toxic bottles, make sure you never heat the bottle, never leave it in the sun, and don't reuse it. And the truth is, in the past, I did use these bottles. You know why? They're just easy and convenient. But I've stopped after doing the research, and I wish I had done so a long time ago. Needless to say, it's never too late. You can for sure still make improvement in your hormone levels at any age. And below this video in the description area, I've got some important links that will help improve your hormones and decrease your risk for cancer. Did you like this? If you found this helpful, give it a thumbs up. Make sure you share the health and let other people know about this video and today's topic so they can benefit as well. Thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.